Hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of the mouth release series. Before we move to the ways to attach the release to the harness, let's talk a little bit about the design, just for the context of the further explanations. So here is the release, right? And this bit is moving, and that's how it holds to the end of the towing rope. So let's this be the end of the towing rope, and let's put it in place. Right now it is still not closed, it is still moving freely. Its own weight is enough for it to open, and that's, by the way, the default state for the mouth release. When it is open, it is actually open. To close it, we need to squeeze the mouthpiece. Have a look what's going on now. So you see, I'm squeezing the mouthpiece, and this bit on top is moving as well. Mouthpiece, bit on top. Notice there is no locking mechanism, so it is closed only when the mouthpiece is squeezed. When it is open, the release is open. When it is closed, the release is closed. As simple as that, no locking. So say I'm opening it, and again, just its own weight is enough for the release to open. As simple as that. But if there is full tension on the rope, shouldn't we match this guy? So here is our little test setup. That's how I'm gonna stress the release. So there is a ring, so it models the towing rope, like going up. So, and here is the release. Right, and I'm attaching it to the ring. And now let's see how strong is the effort to hold my whole weight on this thing. So I'm trying to put as much less weight on my hand as possible. So pretty much everything is on the ring. So as you see, my whole weight, I'm holding it with my fingers, not much efforts. So now, and I'm releasing it, and boom, it goes away. So I can hold my whole weight with just two fingers. So I'm literally holding my whole weight. As you see, not much effort. It is also worth to talk about the mouthpiece separately, or to be specific about the soft padding around it. It is designed in a little bit interesting way. It is not some kind of a soft padding glued in from the both sides of the mouthpiece. It is around webbing wrapped around the metal part, and it is loosely attached. It is not glued in, loosely attached by some kind of weak threads from both sides, so it will not fall away during the normal operations. However, if the thing needs to slide out of your tightly squeezed jaws, there is a good chance that it will be possible for it to make it. It is designed this way with one specific emergency in mind: failure of the release attachment. If the release decides to fly away because the towing rope is still pulling it, it needs to slide off your mouth without pulling your teeth out. With this kind of wrapping, there is a good chance that you'll be able to do that. The chance of an emergency like that is very low. I've been flying with mouth-operated releases for 25 years, and it never happened to me, and I never heard about it happening to my close friends. However, I heard about this happening to people I do not know directly. I can remember two cases. In one case, the release slid away from the mouth as designed, in another case, one of the teeth been damaged. I'm not sure how much it been damaged, but the pilot reported that the tooth been damaged somehow. So a couple of cases I heard about after 25 years of flying. The chance is low, but still not zero, and you need to be aware of that. And the main idea is make sure that the actual release does not fly away from the harness, that it is attached well. And the main idea number two, obviously do not try to change the design of this padding. It is already very good design, and it will have very good chance of saving your teeth in a highly unlikely case of emergency that I described earlier.
A
couple of other things to consider. There is another emergency measure on top of the release. This bit, if you remember, it's a moving bit that moves with the mouse release squeezed, and it holds the locking part in place, right? So imagine that the release is stuck. Then with these tools, you have a chance to unstuck it, like if you really need it. Never happened to me. I never needed it, and to be honest, I doubt that it is a useful measure. But anyway, it is there, and you need to be aware of it. Also, there is some kind of adjustment at the end of the release. So it is just a typical bike technology. You see this bowed and wire that goes through release, and it comes to this end, and it is adjustable by using a little screw at the end of it. I would not recommend touching it unless you really know what you're doing. Normally it comes from the guy who makes them, like already adjusted very well.